This is Coding Math Mini number 4, clamp. So one more quick function this week. Like norm, lerp, and map, this function also has to do with a value and a range. In this case, what we're doing is limiting the value to ensure that it stays within the range. This can be useful for things like validating input. Say you're doing a test grading program. The score for a test can be from 0 to 100%. So the range is 0 to 100. It makes no sense to have a score like minus 15%. So if you enter a value less than the minimum, it returns the minimum. Likewise, you can't really score 120% on a test, assuming there's no extra credit kind of thing going on. So if you pass it a value that's greater than the maximum, it returns the maximum. If the value is in range, it just returns that value. So the function is basically clamping the value between those two points and making sure it doesn't go beyond them on either side. Now you can implement this in a few different ways. You could start with some if statements. So you say if the value is less than min, return min. If it's greater than max, return max. Otherwise, return the value. This is kind of a brute force method, literally writing out the definition of the function in code. Perhaps a better way is to use the built-in math functions, math min and math max, to transform the value. The first line makes sure that the value is no less than min, and the second line makes sure that it is no greater than max. And you can even consolidate that into a one-liner by getting rid of the value variable and inlining that first expression right into the second. Now this may seem like a pretty boring function, but it can actually be very useful and create some neat effects. To demonstrate this visually, I've set up a project. I've created a rect object with x, y, width, and height properties. Then there's the clamp function we just created. Then I listen for the mouse move event. In that handler, I create x and y variables using the event client x and event client y. These get clamped to the size of the rectangle using rect.x for minimum, and then rect.x plus rect.width for maximum, and similar values on the y-axis. Then I clear the canvas, draw that rectangle with a light gray, and then draw the circle with a radius of 10 at that clamped xy position. You might notice that I drew the rectangle a bit larger than the rect object to account for the 10 pixel radius of the circle. And when we run this and move the mouse around, you can see that the circle follows the mouse, but its position is clamped to stay within the area of the rectangle. So like the other functions so far, this is a good one for the utility library, and it's a good one to look for places to use. So that's it for this week. We'll be back next week to talk about the Pythagorean theorem and distance.